Hi students, my name is Ravi Kumar, working as a mathematics faculty in Sri Chaitanya Schools. Today, I would like to discuss one of the easiest chapter in the mathematics, progressions. This chapter's weightage in CBSE board examinations, AP board examinations, as well as Telangana board examinations is around 6 marks. This chapter is not only useful in the board examinations, this chapter is very much useful in all kinds of competitive examinations which involved numerical ability questions. Before going to discuss about the chapter progressions, I want to introduce one more word called sequence. What is the word? Sequence. What is a sequence? Sequence is a list of numbers which follows certain pattern. Once again, I am repeating students, what is a sequence? Sequence is a list of numbers which follows certain pattern, or else we can define as like this. Sequence is a list of numbers which follows particular rule. Sequence is a list of numbers which follows a particular rule. Let us discuss few examples. Here there are several list of numbers, out of which let me judge which list of numbers represents a sequence, which list of numbers will not represent a sequence. Now let us judge the list 1. Here already I have given few numbers. Based on these given 4 numbers, are you able to predict next number? Yes, you can't, because these given numbers are not following any certain pattern. Whereas, observe the list 2. Here the numbers given are 10, 14, 18, 22 and so on. Now, observe the numbers. Here 4 is added to 10 to get 14. 4 is again added to this 14 to get 18. 4 is added to 18 to get 22. Apply the same technique to generate the next number. So, what we should do? Add 4 to this 22, which number we will get? It is 26. Nice. It is the next number is 26. Now, let us continue the same technique to get the next numbers. If I add 4 to this 26, which number I will get? I will get 30 and so on. So, what you have observed in this list of numbers? This list of numbers are following certain pattern. Such list of numbers, what we are going to call now onwards? These are the sequences. Now, this list represents a sequence of numbers. Now, let us discuss another list. Here it is list 3. Now, the numbers, what are the given numbers? 1, 4, 9, 16, so on. Are you able to predict the upcoming numbers? Yes. Here, you identified this 1 is 1 square and this 4 can be written as 2 square, 9 can be written as 3 square, 16 can be written as 4 square. That means, what are the given numbers? Given numbers are, those can also be re-represented as 1 square, 2 square, 3 square as well as 4 square. Now, what will be the next number? Obviously, it is 5 square. 5 square value is 25. Now, what is the next number? It is 6 square, nothing but 36 and so on. That means, these list of numbers also following a certain pattern. So, that this list also represents a sequence. Now, let us discuss about what is a progression. First of all, let me ask you one question. Have you observed any familiar word in the name of progression? Yes, it is nothing but progress. We are very familiar with the word progress. Using this word progress, I want to define progression. A sequence of numbers which are exhibiting the constant progressive nature are called progressions. Once again, I am repeating students, what is a progression. Sequence of numbers which exhibits constant progressive nature are called progressions. Generally, the numbers which involved in the progression are called terms of the progression. Now, we will discuss about arithmetic progression. Simply we call as AP. AP stands for arithmetic progression. Let us see the definition of this arithmetic progression. What is an arithmetic progression? A sequence of numbers in which each term is obtained by adding a fixed number to the preceding term except the first term. Once again I am repeating, students, what is a arithmetic progression? Sequence of numbers in which each term is obtained by adding fixed number to the preceding term except the first term. This fixed number generally we call as common difference. We indicate with small d. We indicate with small d. Generally, this common difference may be positive, this common difference may be negative, this common difference may be zero. Okay. Now, let A is the first term and D is the common difference. According to the definition of an arithmetic progression, how we can generate the arithmetic progression terms? First term as it is we have to write, this is the first term. We need to add this D to A to generate the second term, that means A plus D. A plus D is the second term. So, if I add this D to A plus D, I will get the third term, that means A plus D plus D, nothing but A plus 2D. Now, in order to generate the fourth term, we have to add this D to the third term, that means A plus 2D. A plus 2D plus D, which is nothing but A plus 3D, that so on. This represents arithmetic progression. Now, examine few examples. Are you able to generate arithmetic progression? Yes. How we are generating here? First number 3. To get the next number, we have to add this fixed number to 3. That means it is 3 plus 4, nothing but 7. Now, 7 plus 4, 11. 11 plus 4, 15. 15 plus 4, 19, and so on. Now, coming to the example 2. Here, A is given 10, D is given minus 5. As already I told you, this common difference may be positive, may be negative. Here in this example, I considered D is equal to minus 5. Now, here, generate the sequence. A is equal to 10, take the first term as it is 10. Now, generate the terms by adding this fixed quantity to this 10, so that 10 plus of minus 5, which is nothing but 5. Again, 5 plus minus 5, which is 0. Again, 0 plus of minus 5, it is minus 5, and so on. In the example 3, I have taken A is equal to 11. Now, generate the arithmetic progression. A is equal to 11, first term as it is 11. And the next number we will get by adding this D to the 11, so that it is 11 again. 11 plus 0, how much? 11. Again, 11 plus 0, how much? 11. And again, 11 plus 0, 11. That means, in this arithmetic progression, terms are fixed because we have considered D is equal to 0. Now, observe, students, here in this example 1, the values are increasing. Here in this example, the values are decreasing. Here in this example, the value is constant. So, here I have considered D is greater than 0. So that I will get the arithmetic progression in which the terms are going to be increasing. Such type of arithmetic progressions we call as increasing arithmetic progression. What is it? Increasing arithmetic progression, simply we call as AP. No, so increasing AP. Why the values are decreasing here? Because I am adding negative number to the fixed number, so that I am getting the decreasing values. That means whenever d is less than 0, which type of arithmetic progression we are generating here? It is decreasing. It is decreasing arithmetic progression. Now, if I take d is equal to 0, all the terms of the progressions are fixed. That means it is a constant progression. That means when d is equal to 0, we are generating constant progression, constant arithmetic progression. Let us redefine this arithmetic progression. This arithmetic progression is, again we are defining as sequence of numbers in which the difference of any two consecutive terms is constant is called an AP. Once again I am repeating, students, sequence of numbers in which the difference of any two consecutive terms is constant is called an AP. Let a1, a2, a3, so on, an are the sequence of numbers. If a2 minus a1 is equal to a3 minus a2 is equal to, so on, an minus an minus 1, then we say that a1, a2, a3, so on are in arithmetic progression. Using the first definition, we can generate the arithmetic progression. Using this second definition, we can verify whether the given sequence of numbers are in arithmetic progression or not. Now, let us take an AP 6, 9, 12, 15, so on. Now, I want to add 4 to each term of this AP. I want to add 4 to each term of this AP. Now, let us write the new sequence. What will be the new sequence? 6 plus 4 is 10, 9 plus 4 is 13, 12 plus 4 is 16, 15 plus 4 is 19, and so on. It is the new sequence. Can you judge whether it is in the arithmetic progression or not? Try to do this. 13 minus 10, 3, 16 minus 13, 3, 19 minus 16, 3. That means difference between the consecutive terms is fixed, so that this sequence is in arithmetic progression. What I have did here? I have added a fixed value to each term of an AP. Then the resultant new sequence is in AP or not? Yes, resultant new sequence is also in arithmetic progression. In the similar manner, this time I want to subtract 1 from each term of this AP. Now, what will be the resultant new sequence this time? Here I want to subtract 1 from each term now. So, 6 minus 1, it is 5. 9 minus 1, it is 8. 12 minus 1, it is 11. 15 minus 1, it is 14, and so on. Now, again, check this new sequence is in arithmetic progression or not. How to check it out? Just by calculating the difference of consecutive terms and verifying whether the difference is constant or not. 8 minus 5, 3. 11 minus 8, 3. 14 minus 11, 3. That means the difference of consecutive terms is constant. This sequence also represents an AP. What I have did here? I have subtracted a fixed quantity from each term of an AP. The resultant sequence also representing arithmetic progression. Automatically, here in the first case, I have added first fixed quantity to each term. In the second case, I have subtracted a particular quantity from each term. Now, what I am going to do? Right. I am going to multiply each term of an AP with a fixed value 2. Now, what will be the resultant sequence now? 6 into 2, it is 12. Again, 9 minus 2, it is 18. 12 into 2, it is 24. 15 into 2, it is 30, and so on. This is the new sequence. Again, verify whether this sequence is in AP or not. 18 minus 12, 6. 24 minus 8, 6. 30 minus 24, 6. That means we are getting consecutive terms difference is fixed. So that again this sequence is representing arithmetic progression. That means if I multiply each term of a given AP with a fixed number, then the resultant sequence is also AP. Nice. And last and final arithmetic operation, division. Remember students, division we have to perform with non-zero numbers only. Don't divide with 0, because division with 0 is prohibited in the mathematics. No. Now, I want to divide each term of a given AP with 3. Now, tell me what will be the resultant sequence? 6 by 3. 6 by 3 is 2. Nice. Next, 9 by 3, it is 3. 12 by 3, 4. 15 by 3, it is 5, and so on. This is the resultant sequence. Now, again, it is very easy for us to check this list of numbers are in arithmetic progression, because the consecutive terms difference is fixed. 3 minus 2 is 1, 4 minus 3 is 1, 5 minus 4 is also 1. So, it is representing arithmetic progression. That means, let me conclude the sentences. If I take an arithmetic progression, if I want to add or subtract a fixed value from the each term of given AP, then the resultant sequences always represents an arithmetic progression. And moreover, if I multiply or divide, if I multiply or divide with a fixed number to each and every term of an arithmetic progression, then the resultant sequences again they are in arithmetic progression. Now, I want to discuss general form of an AP. Let us take A is the first term, D is the common difference. As per our previous definition, how to generate the terms of arithmetic progression when the first term and the common difference are given? Yes, A is the first term already has told, and second term is A plus D, third term is A plus 2D, fourth term will be A plus 3D, and so on. This form we call as general form of an AP. Now, come to here, the first term A1 I am assuming as A, and the second term of the arithmetic progression A2 is equal to, what will be the number here? It is A plus D. Now, A3, that means third term of AP, here third term is A plus 2D. Now, fourth term here is A plus 3D, that means A4 is equal to A plus 3D, and so on. Now, what you have observed here, the first term is A1, which is nothing but A. Second term is A2, which is nothing but A plus D. Third term is A3, which is nothing but A plus 2D. A4 is nothing but A plus 3D. Just look at the pattern. Look at this pattern of numbers. Can you say, what is AN? What is the meaning of AN? The number which is located in the nth place. What is AN? The number in the sequence, or the number in an arithmetic progression which is located in nth place. It means nth place number. We are discussing about nth place number. Just observe the pattern here. In the first term, there is no D. In the second term, only one D. In the third term, there are two D's. Here in the fourth term, there are three D's. Whereas, in the nth term, by observing the pattern, previous patterns,
we can easily say that it is a plus one number smaller than the place value, that means n minus 1 times of d. Here it is 2 times of d in the third place, third term. Here in the fourth term 3 times of d, in the nth term n minus 1 times of d, that will be the nth term. That means what is the nth term? An is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. This is called nth term of an AP. This nth term of an AP also we call as general term of an AP. What we call? It is general term. What is the benefit of this general term? Using this general term, we can directly calculate the required term without calculating, without knowing the previous terms. For example, I can able to calculate directly 100th term of an AP without knowing the second term, third term, fourth term and so on, 99th term. Directly we can able to calculate 100th term. That will be the benefit of this general term. Let us discuss with an example. Now, the given AP, in the given AP, we have to find 30th term. Find the 30th term of an AP, 10, 7, 4 and so on. Here, given AP is, what is given AP? 10, 7, 4, so on. So, by observing the given sequence, we can easily identify the first term. What is the first term? Here, first term is 10. And the common difference, d is equal to, what will be the common difference? Second term minus first term, that means 7 minus 10, which is equal to minus 3. Which place term we supposed to calculate? 30th term, that means the term which is there in the 30th place, that means n is equal to 30. We know that. What do you know? We given the formula to calculate nth term. An is equal to a plus n minus 1 times of d. This is the formula. Substitute these values in this formula, then a 30 is equal to a plus 10 plus 30 minus 1 times of minus 3. Be careful, my dear students, here the calculation part. That is equal to 10 plus 30 minus 1 is 29 times of minus 3, which is equal to 10 minus 87. 10 minus 87, how much? It is minus 77. That means, what is the number in the 30th place? 30th place number, that means 30th term is minus 77. It is minus 77. Okay. Just now we have defined the formula to calculate nth term of an AP. What is that? An is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. Here, how many unknown values are there? An is one of the unknown. A is also unknown. N is unknown, as well as d is also unknown. In the examinations, generally, they will give three values and they ask us to find the fourth value. In all kinds of board examinations, there is one important model problem. Let us try to discuss that problem here. Which term of the AP 3, 8, 13, 18 and so on is 78? My dear students, first of all, try to identify what is given and what is need to find. Here, he has given one AP. From this AP, we can identify the first term and as well as we can calculate the common difference. Already he mentioned that the sequence is itself AP, so that enough to calculate one difference. Second term minus first term. Here the second term is 8 and the first term is 3. Therefore, 8 minus 3 is equal to 5 is the common difference.
Now, I am assuming in this list of number, 78 will appear in the nth place. That means an is equal to 78. Here, I don't know the n value. So, I want to calculate this n value. As we know, as per the formula, an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. Substitute known values in this formula to calculate unknown value. So, an is 78, a is equal to 3, n value we don't know, and d is equal to 5. On simplification, see here, if I transfer this 3 to left side, 78 minus 3 is 75 is equal to n minus 1 of 5. Now, this n minus 1 is equal to transferring this 5 to the left side, we will get 75 by 5, which is 15. That is, n minus 1 is equal to 15. Therefore, n is equal to 16. What's our conclusion? 16th term of given AP is 78.